in my early 20s, I was diagnosed for having ADHD. Maybe this was a misdiagnosis, who knows, but I was on three different types of medication. First was Ritalin, second being Concerta, and the third was Vyvanse. And Concerta worked really well for me. My grades were up, I was reading faster and being a lot more productive. However, when it came to these central nervous stimulants, they had absolutely terrible side effects, from feeling irritable to having these like strange energy crashes during the day, and I virtually had like no appetite, which is what then led me to look for safer alternatives. Let's talk about nootropics, because what are nootropics? They're used to improve cognition with like memory, mood, focus, concentration. So that's what I discussed on this channel. If you haven't yet subscribed, do click subscribe and let's talk about some nice alternatives. The first being lion's mane, also known as Hericium erinaceus. You can actually find it on trees. And I feel like lion's mane is really appropriate for somebody who's maybe challenged with ADD and ADHD, because it's not as if it really helps you with focus, more so as it eliminates your anxiety and it can really eliminate distractibility. In this neat study here, what happened was a number of individuals had cookies which either had lion's mane or did not contain lion's mane. And the group that was taking lion's mane cookies did experience a boost of concentration as well as a decreased irritability and decreased anxiety. It's helped me become very productive, especially when combining it with a stimulant, because lion's mane doesn't really seem to give you the energy you want to help you be more productive, but more so will help you to work smarter. You'll find that you're calmer, you're more present, you have a better relationship with yourself, a better relationship with your work, and from a socialist perspective, you'll be really interested in people. Not only may you be in a better mood, but it seems to lengthen your attention span to some extent. Typically, I'm taking 300 milligrams 2 to 3 times a day, ends up being something like 9 a.m., again at 3 p.m., and then again at 6 p.m. And I found that with this nootropic, it's not that stimulating, therefore it is okay to actually take before bed. This is one of my favorite nootropics. Without question, it's changed my life, which I've talked about in this video over here. You may find that helpful. Then the next alternative would be phenylpiracetam. I absolutely love this stuff. What's different about it is that this is actually more physically stimulating than it is mentally. Don't know if you can see that. It looks pretty much like an amino acid would. It's this white kind of texture. And with respect to improving your focus, this is different than modafinil in that it seems to like work after a couple of hours and then it does get you going. And overall, you should get some sort of benefit for about 10 to 12 hours. One ingestion, I like it first thing in the morning, just about 100 milligrams. Not every day, because you can build somewhat of a tolerance to it. Maybe 2 or 3 times per week when I really need it, or maybe a day when I have more work than typically. The way you're likely to feel is a lot more alert, aroused, you can say more energetic. It's like your need for taking breaks is almost eliminated. The only thing which makes it a little bit different than other nootropics is that it's physically energizing, maybe even more than it needs to be. So because of that, you can find yourself being so stimulated that you don't know what to do with all that energy. Like, I can relate to times when I'd be doing work behind my computer and like all of a sudden I need to go for a run. But what's so is when it comes to like reading or really trying to get immersed in some sort of work, you're magnificently able to eliminate distractions and really have that tunnel vision to get through your work to ensure it's completed. And if you were to ask about side effects, none you should be too concerned about. Rapid heart beating is pretty common given that it's a stimulant, and as well, do not take this too close to bed, because believe me, it will definitely keep you up. And our next nootropic to help with ADHD and ADD is Mucuna Pruriens. This is the form that I'm taking. 2 capsules equals 800 milligrams. This is a tropical legume native to Africa, so consider it like a natural nootropic. But that being said, it is still relatively strong and may not be something you want to consider taking every single day, because what Mucuna Pruriens is going to do is raise your dopamine levels. Dopamine is a very important neurotransmitter that's especially responsible when it comes to focus and mood regulation, which is one of the reasons why Mucuna Pruriens is very often used to help with Parkinson's disease. And what you can expect is slightly higher energy levels, definitely increased focus. It is kind of similar to L-tyrosine, but it's more efficient in the way it works, as tyrosine is gonna convert to L-dopa and then convert to dopamine, whereas Mucuna Pruriens is so strong as it just converts directly into dopamine. When you're looking at the Mucuna Pruriens product that you are considering, I would highly recommend that you look at the percentage of L-dopa. This is 800 milligrams per serving, of which is 40% L-dopa. That's actually on the higher side. You'll typically find something less, like 10 to 20%. But what this means is that you're getting the benefit as far as it increasing your dopamine production. This is what one of the pill looks like here. But the real neat use of Mucuna pruriens is perhaps when you're getting off of a central nervous stimulant. Let's say when you're off of Concerta, generally you'd experience withdrawals, which feels like social isolation, being in a worse mood. I've experienced it. As a matter of fact, I discussed it in this video here. You may find helpful. That's where Mucuna pruriens can really be helpful, because consider this like something which is going to help with focus, yet it's going to act on different receptors. Therefore, you're able to kind of clear Concerta out of your system and still be somewhat productive during that withdrawal period when you're adjusting back to your normal lifestyle and your usual self. This is our next nootropic here. It's called L-theanine. What is it? It's an amino acid that's typically found in green tea, but you're not getting enough of it no matter how many green teas you happen to have. So for that reason, a lot of people are supplementing with it, and it's really calming too. You can take it first thing in the morning, or you can even take it before bed because it's known to somewhat help with your sleep quality. Of the five nootropics, this is probably the safest in my opinion. I've used this for a number of years. I've not really found it to have any bad side effects. What it's most known for is ingesting it along with caffeine, which typically looks like a ratio of 1 caffeine to 2 L-theanine. So like 100 milligrams of caffeine along with 200 milligrams of L-theanine. The way I like taking it is once in the morning with my serving of caffeine, and then I'll sprinkle a little bit throughout the day. Maybe I'll take like another 50 milligrams once at noon and then once again at 5 p.m. And what you'll find is that immediately you feel a little bit relaxed, a little bit calm. If you really wanna have, let's say, a solid 3 hours of productivity, believe me, if you combine this with caffeine, it's very effective because caffeine is gonna energize you, whereas this is gonna help you with your concentration and allow you to like work smarter, whereas caffeine will help you work harder. You can find a lot of capsules that conveniently have the necessary amount of caffeine and L-theanine. This is one I really like. It's called Smart Caffeine by Natural Stacks. This has 100 milligrams of caffeine along with L-theanine, and I also have the Nootropics Depot product. I made a comprehensive video on trying out L-theanine and what it's like, which I will link right over here. This is the next nootropic that'll definitely enhance your focus. It's called Rhodiola rosea. It's without question made me more money, improved my grades. It's an adaptogenic herb that's known for fighting stress. So we're not only talking eliminating stress, but allowing you to tolerate more stress. And really of the herbal supplements or adaptogens like ashwagandha, bacopa minieri, I would say Rhodiola rosea is definitely the most effective when it comes to focus and fighting ADD or ADHD. Looking at examiner.com, 14 studies showing it helps with fatigue. There's studies showing it helps with cognition, subjective well-being. And then of course, what we're looking for, attention. The attention studies were done with individuals aged 18 to 29, and they were only using 100 milligrams per day, yet they were still seeing results. This is really powerful stuff. I'm talking from the moment you take it, you should feel somewhat alert. It will suppress your appetite to some extent, kind of like how a stimulant like Adderall would, which makes it ideal for losing weight and really fighting stress, not only mental stress, but physical stress. I really like to describe it as a nap in a pill, because rather than taking your 20-minute nap around 2 o'clock, you can just pop some Rhodiola rosea and it will give you a boost of attention and really allow you to work throughout the day, especially when it comes to fighting fatigue. I think that anybody that's working 10 hours per day or longer should definitely be taking some Rhodiola rosea. And this is one of those tools kind of similar to caffeine, in which you would take as you need. Like I find on days when I'm working a little bit longer, I would take some extra Rhodiola rosea. But the way in which I'm typically taking it is 300 milligrams twice per day. I'm not using it first thing in the morning because it's gonna help with fatigue. In the morning, you don't really wake up fatigued, so go figure. What it typically looks like is once at 2 p.m. and then again at 6 p.m., really depending on what time of the day which I wake up and have my most important activities. But this is a great supplement. The side effects are generally uncommon, but some may experience irritability, maybe a little bit of anxiety, but these occurrences are very rare. And this video would not be complete without talking about NuPEPT. NuPEPT is as well very, very effective when it comes to focus, attention, being more productive. It's just that it doesn't seem to work with everyone. Maybe 50% of people seem to respond to it or respond positively. Some people get irritable, but ingesting NuPEPT has really been instrumental in helping me build my sales career, as well as the racetam, specifically Pruriens, which perhaps I'll talk about in another video. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. Do click subscribe, and I will look forward to seeing you all next time. Take care, guys.